One reason why he might be withholding his endorsement is that there's a strong chance that Super Tuesday is going to be a big mush ball,
right,
and that we're then going to be into this game of who can get the super delegates and who can put together 2,025 delegates by the time they get to Denver. And he might want to be a, even though he doesn't have any delegates, but a, you know, a player at that table.
And there was danger in him not waiting until after February 5th to do this?
Well, conceivably, you know, he could then see whether it is still up for grabs and then at that point get in. But I think it's more likely that he'll do something in the next few days.
I do, too. And, I mean, I think that somebody talked to him, and somebody like Teddy, but not necessarily Senator Kennedy, and said to him, it's in your interest to do this now, in the same way Jim Baker got George Bush to drop out when it was against Reagan. It's in your interest to do this now and not simply wait and believe you can be a factor at the convention, because it's unlikely that that's going to happen. And there's the time to use some sense of leverage you have something important.
I do think that right at this very moment, the campaign with the juice to make that argument is the Obama campaign. Yeah. You know, they could make the argument, the train's leaving the station. Look what happened this week,
sure,
with Teddy Kennedy and Caroline Kennedy. And if you want to be on this train, you're going to have to get on right now. At the same time, though, Hillary Clinton, who spoke with Edwards a couple of times this week, could be making the argument, look, why don't you just wait a little bit and see what happens on
Super
Tuesday?
Maybe something big here for you.
Because, you know, I'm sure you're going to have an important, you would have an important part in the Clinton administration, except maybe if you endorsed Obama right now.
Yeah, but I mean, he's going to have an important part in either administration, I assume, if he endorses either of them now.
I think there's a natural role for him, though, in the Obama administration. It's not attorney general, as a lot of people have been talking about. He could end up being that. But Obama keeps talking about having the health care debate on C-SPAN. He's mentioned this several times, where he would have all of the different players.
It's a playoff of the world. Last time we had a health care debate.
The insurance companies, right. Well, he does it partly because it was done in secret by Hillary. But I think it's actually a very intriguing idea to have everybody try to defend their positions in public. The insurance companies, the drug companies, the doctors. Everybody's at the table. Remember, and Edwards at first said, well, they shouldn't do it that way. You'll get taken to the cleaners. But Obama wants to do it, and I think he's right that you can have a big public education. Well, who should the president or president-elect designate to do the questioning of the insurance companies and the drug companies who are at that table? Who better than John Edwards,
a former trial lawyer,
to do the cross-examination of them and to illuminate the weakness of some of their positions?
Join us online at charlierose.com.